If you like to talk to tomatoes, if a squash can make you smile, if you like to waltz with potatoes up and down the produce aisle, have we got a show for you?
VeggieTales, 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 VeggieTales.
Broccoli, celery, gotta be
VeggieTales.
Lima beans, collard greens, peachy keen,
VeggieTales.
Cauliflower, sweet and sour, half an hour,
VeggieTales. There's never, ever, ever, ever been a show like VeggieTales. There's never, ever, ever, ever been a show like VeggieTales. It's time for VeggieTales.
You were lying in your bed. You were feeling kind of sleepy, but you couldn't close your eyes because the room was getting creepy.
Were those eyeballs in the closet?
Was that Godzilla in the hall? There was something big and hairy casting shadows on the wall. Now your heart is beating like a drum. Your skin is getting clammy. There's 100 tiny monsters jumping right into your jammies.
What are you gonna do?
I'm going to call the police.
No, you don't need to do anything.
What? Why?
Because...
God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV. Oh, God is bigger than the boogeyman, and he's watching out for you and me.
So when I'm lying in my bed and the furniture starts creeping, I'll just laugh and say, hey, cut that out, and get back to my sleeping, 'cause I know that God's the biggest and he's watching all the while. So when I get scared, I'll think of him and close my eyes and smile.
I'm sorry that I scared you when you saw me on TV.
Well, that's okay, 'cause now I know that God is taking care of me.
God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV. Oh, God is bigger than the boogeyman, and he's watching out for you and me.
One more time!
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Laddie, the part of the show where Laddie comes out and sings. a silly song. So without further ado, Silly Songs with Laddie.
The Water Buffalo Song.
Everybody's got a water buffalo. Yours is fast, but mine is slow. Oh, where'd we get them? I don't know. But everybody's got a water buffalo. Ooh. I took my buffalo to the store. Got his head stuck in the door. Squeezed some lima beans on the floor. Oh, everybody got a...
Stop right this instant. What do you think you're doing? You can't say everyone's got a water buffalo and everyone does not have a water buffalo. We're going to get nasty letters saying, where's my water buffalo? Why don't I have a water buffalo? And are you prepared to deal with that? I don't think so. Just stop being so silly.
This has been Silly Songs with Laddie. Tune in next time to hear Laddie sing.
Everybody got a baby kangaroo. Yours is pink, but mine is blue. Hers was small.
I am King Darius. I've had a dream. I'm feeling rather frightened, and I wish someone would tell me what it means.
We are your wise men.
Yes, that is true.
And though we're using all our wisdom, we're afraid we can't explain your dream to you.
What? But there is one who is wiser still, and Daniel is his name. So before you take another sleeping pill,
my name is Daniel. That much is true. But it is God who gives me wisdom, and through me he will explain your dreams to you.
His name is Daniel. That's what he said. But when he talks about this God of his, I think he's kind of loony in the head. I do.
Well, Daniel was able to explain the king's dream, and this made the king very happy.
Daniel, you have enlightened me. Your job I will expand. From now on, I want you to sit right beside me as the second in command.
This was very good news for Daniel, but very bad news for the wise men. You see, each one of them wanted to be second in command. Now that Daniel got the job, the wise men would have to do whatever he said. This made the wise men very unhappy, and they immediately started thinking of ways to get rid of Daniel.
Oh no, what we gonna do? The king likes Daniel more than me and you. Oh no, what we gonna do? We gotta get him out of here. Oh no, what we gonna do? The king likes Daniel more than me and you. Oh no, what we gonna do? We gotta get him out of here.
We could throw him in the dungeon. We could let him rot in jail. We could drag him to the ocean. Have him eaten by a whale.
We could throw him in the tiger's let him float a while. Then we'll all sit back and watch him eat a hungry crocodile. Put him on a camel's back and send him off to Ur with a cowboy hat without a brim, a boot without a spur. Oh, we could give him jelly donuts, take him all away, or we could fill his ears with cheese balls and his nostrils with sorbet. We could use him as a footstool or a table to play Scrabble on, then tie him up and beat him up and throw him out of Babylon.
Or...
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Oh. I like it.
It's sneaky.
And it just...
might...
work.
We could use him as a footstool or a table to play Scrabble on, then tie him up and beat him up and throw him out of Babylon.
The very next morning, the wise men appeared before King Darius to try to trap Daniel with their scheme.
You wanted to see me?
We've got some news, good King Darius. We fear your position is precarious. There are some people here in Babylon who won't give you your due. They'd rather bow to other men.
Can this be so?
'Tis true.
Oh dear.
We've brought a solution of our own design. If you'll just sign this paper on the dotted line. It's an edict stating most concisely what we're all to do. We must bow our heads or bend our knees before no one but you.
I see. Just one more time now, let's see if I've got this straight. A law to prove once and for all that I am great. If I'm the king, no one must doubt my full supremacy. So from this day forth, my citizens will pray to only me. Yes, but what if they don't?
If they don't obey, any citizen will be thrown into the lion's den.
Oh, yes? Well, I guess that would do it. All right then, good work, man. Ta-ta!
So the law was passed, the deed was done. Daniel's troubles had just begun.
Everyone in Babylon heard about the new law, including Daniel. But Daniel also knew God's law, and God's law told him that he should only pray to God.
Oh, it's not so scary down here. A little musty, but not so scary. Oh no, what am I gonna do? It looks like I'm gonna end up as lions too.
Don't cry, Daniel. Fear not. Daniel, don't you know you're not alone? There is one who is watching you. He listens when you pray. And though it seems this time you won't get through, God has made.
Even though he still didn't know what to expect, Daniel felt better when he remembered that God was taking care of him, even in the lion's den.
Surely your God is above all men. Now I understand. For even at the bottom of the lion's den, you were in his hand.
We are the grapes of wrath. We'll never take a bath. It is our style to seldom smile and never laugh.
We are the
grapes of wrath. So stay out of our path. There's no escape from cranky grapes. We are the grapes of wrath.
I'm Bob.
I'm Paul.
This is our brood.
We're grumpy and we know where.
That's Tom and Rosie.
They're both rude.
And not afraid to show it.
We're not the folks you'd like to meet. We bicker by the hour. While other sweet.
We're really rather sour.
As we go driving by, I might spit in your eye.
Or throw a snake in your milkshake to make you cry.
Shove with the
grapes of wrath. So stay out of our path. There's no escape from cranky grapes. We are the grapes of wrath. There's no escape from cranky grapes. We are the grapes of wrath.
Some veggies went to CCC to see what they could CCC, but all that they could CCC was the bottom of the deep blue CCC.
See?
You know that in love we can forgive. It is the only way to live. Obey God and see that we can live in harmony. Since God has forgiven us, it's true. You forgive me, I'll forgive you. I'm gonna start to show forgiveness from my heart.
Wow, that worked!
Right, if only there was a way for us to get back home.
Yeah, well at least we're all friends again. Hey! Has anybody seen the professor?
Nope.
Voila!
Hey! Do you like it? I made it entirely out of bamboo and coconuts. Pretty good, huh? Well, climb aboard!
Hey, Bob?
Yeah, Larry?
Next summer, let's just sell lemonade, like everyone else.
That sounds like a good idea.
You know that in love we can forgive. Hey man, it is the only way to live. Obey God and see that we can live in harmony. Since God has forgiven us, it's true. You forgive me, I'll forgive you. I'm gonna start to show forgiveness from my heart. So do your part and show forgiveness from your heart.
Is that music?
I'm busy, busy, dreadfully busy. You've no idea what I have to do. Busy, busy, shockingly busy, much, much too busy for you.
Oh, I see.
We're busy, busy, dreadfully busy. You've no idea what we have to do. Busy, busy, shockingly busy, much, much too busy for you.
'Cause we're busy, busy, frightfully busy. More than a bumblebee, more than an ant. Busy, busy, horribly busy. We'd love to help, but we can't.
Ta-ta!
He has a shoe and I have a pot. But when we look deeper,
it's time to perform a good deed. And when you finish, you'll find that it's true. When you make them feel better, you'll feel better too.
Here, let me help you.
Thank you.
Oh, love your neighbor. When someone helps you, then you'll understand. When you
And now it's
time for Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song. Our curtain opens as Larry, having just finished his morning bath, is searching for his hairbrush. Having no success, Larry cries out,
"Oh, where is my hairbrush? Oh, where is my hairbrush? Oh, where, 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 oh, where is my hairbrush?"
Having heard his cry, Pa Grape enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in a towel, Pa regains his composure and reports.
"I think I saw a hairbrush back there."
"Back there is my hairbrush. Back there is my hairbrush. Back there, oh where, back there, oh where, oh where, back there, is my hairbrush."
Having heard his joyous proclamation, Junior Asparagus enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in a towel, Junior regains his composure and comments,
"Why do you need a hairbrush? You don't have any hair!"
Larry is taken aback. The thought had never occurred to him. No hair? What will this mean? What will become of him? What will become of his hairbrush? Larry wonders,
"No hair for my hairbrush. No hair for my hairbrush. No hair, no hair, no where, no hair, no hair, no hair, no where, back there, no hair for my hairbrush."
Having heard his wonderings, Bob the Tomato enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in a towel, Bob regains his composure and confesses,
"Larry, that old hairbrush of yours, well, you never use it. You don't really need it, so, well, I'm sorry. I didn't know, but I gave it to the peach. Cause he's got hair."
Feeling a deep sense of loss, Larry stumbles back and laments,
"Not fair, oh my hairbrush. Not fair, my poor hairbrush. Not fair, not fair, no hair, not fair, no where, no hair, not fair, not fair, not fair, my little hairbrush."
Having heard his lament, the peach enters the scene. Himself in a towel, both Larry and the peach are shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of each other. But recognizing Larry's generosity, the peach is thankful.
"Thanks for the hairbrush."
Yes, good has been done here. The peach exits the scene. Larry smiles, but still feeling an emotional attachment for the hairbrush, calls out,
"Take care of my hairbrush. Take care, oh my hairbrush. Take care, don't dare not care. Take care, nice hair, no fair. Take care of my hairbrush."
The end.
Ever seen a boy with funny clothes? A girl with braces on her teeth or freckles on her nose? Some kids call them oddballs. Some kids call them weird.
Is it my imagination, or does Aunt Ruth have a beard?
God makes lots of people in all colors, shapes, and sizes. He loves them very much, and what we need to realize is that calling people names because they're different is wrong. Instead, we need to look on them in love and sing this song.
I can be your friend.
Some are skinny, some are stout.
But the inside is the part that we're supposed to care about.
Aye, that's where we got feelings that are very much the same.
And so instead of weirdo, I think friend's a better name.
I can be your friend.
La la la.
I can be your friend.
La la la.
If your hair is red or yellow, we can have lunch.
It's time to talk about what we learned today.
And so what we have learned applies to our lives today. And God has a lot to say in His book.
Bamboo, bamboo, bamboo.
You see, we know that God's word is for everyone. And now that our song is done, we'll take